BMW M4 G82, 6 months later, is it still good? All the cars look pretty when they come from the factory, but how do they perform and how do they look after you really use it? We use that baby daily, so I can tell you what I really like about the car, what I don't like. It's not the five things I love, five things I hate. Different story. That's something like a long-term review. And yeah, let's start with the front. And today I will need your input. I really will need your help so you can decide how we will proceed with that car. You will be the one who decides what we will do and what we won't do. Let's start at the front. We really missed the time frame to have proper PPF to secure the front properly. Decision number one is swap colors. But we all love the color. You all love the color. Everyone loves the color. And everyone loves the color scheme so far with the wheels. So this might be a solution to repaint it, put proper PPF on it, swap the grill. Of course, which grill is possible for us? The Vorsteiner grill is a thing. The CSL grill, I really don't like. If you like the grill and you vote for the CSL grill, I will not install it. I will not install it. If you find another solution, please feel free just to mention that. But the CSL grill for me is not an option, not at all. The lip really performs well for us. There's just one little scratch right here. The inlets perform very well for us. Of course, we will paint that. You already decided to paint that in body color. And right now, option number one is to stay with the color scheme. Option number two, I will put a picture right here. And then you can decide what the color of the BMW will be for 2024. Decision number one. Decision number two, fenders. There is a new option in the market from Alpha N, and we are partnering with Alpha N. So this could be an option to swap the fenders. I will put a picture right here and you can decide new fenders or not. Decision number two. Decision number three, the trunk and a spoiler. We could swap the decklid. We could get it from the 4 series for $400 or $500. And we could install a wing. I don't really like the swan neck spoilers. So Adro really put a nice spoiler solution into the market, but I don't like where you mount it. I'll put the picture down here so you can decide. Maybe we would be able to manufacture by ourselves, but just for show and shine, because we will not be able to ride it in Germany with a street legal license. So wing is an option. For me personally, I like wings, but you can decide wing or not. Decision number four, and this is potentially the hardest. We could swap suspension to get lower, but this would be air suspension. And when we will do that, we need to swap wheels as well because they are too big for air suspension. So decision number four, toughest, stay static, stay with the wheels, or get an air suspension and swap wheels. So now we got four decisions to make how we'll proceed with the car. But nevertheless, I will explain you a bit more about my long-term review when we drive. Let's go to German Autobahn. You all love German Autobahn, don't you? I really wasn't that soft to the car, so for that short period, I drove a lot. And I mean a lot, because we went to Milano, Lake Garda and Zurich 2 weeks ago, I think. We didn't went there with the camera, we just took some photos. That's why I'm ready to make that kind of long-term review, because we drove it like 2,500 kilometers in a row, and I drive it almost daily. I do all my shit with that car. Performance wise, like you already know, for me it's the best budget solution at the moment, and I think it will not change. Of course, the BMW M2 is a real competitor, and when it's just about performance, the M2 is the better buy, or will be the better buy, I think, even when you want to go on track. But if you want to have a daily solution and you want people to sit behind of you, the M4 really gives you enough space and enough comfort, and it gives you the luxury BMW wanted to achieve with that car. I have the direct comparison to the F80 and the F82, and it's a lot more luxury than the F-Series. The F-Series, comfort-wise, you really cannot compare it, because everyone who steps into that car and rides with me is like, wow, it's really that comfortable. I didn't expect that. And it's true. It is hella comfortable. It's really a nice daily driver with a lot of power. And that's what I didn't expect as well, because for me, the F-Series was quite uncomfortable. Of course, we had the suspension upgrade, and I can really recommend, if you have the F or the G-Series, do suspension first. It is your go-to solution to have a better car. One benefit I didn't talk about yet, we have that massive front lip, and we are really low, and we didn't hit the asphalt with the front lip yet. So I'm really happy. I can go to every parking lot in Frankfurt, and I went to Munich, I went to Milano, and even Milano worked out. The seats are in a condition I wouldn't be happy as a real BMW customer. It's a little bit wobbly and it doesn't shine anymore, and I think this is something you could be angry about. So daily driving is possible, but you need to be sure that maybe the leather quality will not carry you more than 100k kilometers. I think this is something BMW could improve for newer models. And now, this is one of the sketchiest roads we have in the city. One of the sketchiest roads you can drive on. And it's, what about you? It's okay?
Hard to hold
it's
the camera.
It's shaky, but it's still comfortable. I went here with the SQ8 from the previous video from last week, and that was sketchy as fuck. Let's talk about the sound. We made that sound improvement and we installed the Venturi intake, which is a must. But exhaust wise, I don't feel that I need the new exhaust. The exhaust sound is poor stock wise, but with the exhaust valve control, I think it's working out. I don't miss it. Another solution would be, of course, the muffler, to change the muffler. To kill OPF in Germany is not an option. You get directly sued. I could recommend that you can spend 6 to 8K for an exhaust solution for better parts, for more important parts, and this would be, for me, wheels and suspension first. Carbon fiber, if you don't have the carbon fiber exterior package, and even if you have it, you need to have some more additional parts when you want to complete the look, as you already have 4 decisions to make. One more decision came to my mind, and it's the hood. Is the hood, or is a vented hood, really an option? For me, the vents in the hood solution from Alpha N are really, really huge, and I think you need to love it. And I'm not 100% sure if the Sansibar Metallic will work out with the hood with the really huge vents, because the contrast is really, really strong. And I think we need to render that first. But when we swap colors to the color I showed you before, I think the contrast is not that huge anymore. And I think this will work out even more. So when we swap colors, I think the vented hood is an option. Right now, I'm not sure. You can decide. Hood or no hood. Performance-wise, you don't have any decision to take, because we already decided that we want to pump that baby up. I think 700 plus horsepower is a good option to run it for rear wheel. Oh, for rear-wheel drive, and I think we just can reach that when we swap the cut to have a new downpipe, and I think the muffler could be an option. Right now, I don't see to spend 6K for a muffler, but when we can just reach 695 without muffler and could be able to reach 700 plus with the muffler, I think we will buy the muffler then. And right now we went to the entry of German Autobahn, and you already know that it's the only possibility to fully smash your car to the limit, and there is a limit. Let's go to 100 kilometers per hour first and push it to the ground, push the pedal to the metal. This is really the limit for that car. It's 255, and maybe the video time code shows us how long it takes to reach max speed. But yeah, it's really fast and it feels fast, but you feel that there's a huge potential to go much faster, and I think we totally want that. So a lot of things will come. You really can decide what we will do with it. And maybe we will swap wheels sooner than later, maybe we will swap suspension sooner than later. It's all open and it's all on you and on our taste, and let's simply combine that. You love the car so far, I really love it, and this is why we will not give it away that easy. I think that car will stay. Another car will come soon, it's a promise. And yeah, maybe another car will come soon. But the M4 will stay, and I think it will be our base, our main base, to let the community decide what will happen with it. And what I really, really love about the car, it doesn't get any hate. Wherever I drive, wherever I go, people don't stare at me. When I'm on the road with the Lamborghini, or I don't know, even when I drive the AMG GT, GTC, GTR, whatever, people hate these cars. I don't know why. But with the BMW M4 in our current spec, everyone loves it. And that's the main reason we will stay with the car. And that's the main reason I bought it, because I already knew. Usually you talk about problems when you talk about cars. I will mention it even when we don't have any problems, because it's a real benefit that you don't have any struggle with the car. And we have a lot of M4 owners in our customer circle. They just have the brake issue for the moment, so there is nothing to talk about which really is that serious when it comes to problems with the G-Series. I have one partner with a differential problem, but I honestly think it's because of his driving. So far we can tell, long-term wise, it's a good buy. If you consider to buy a G-Series, G81, G82, G83, it's a nice buy. And I would personally buy it again. For me, there's still no comparison, and I think it will take some time that we have some in the market. And all the electric hype, I think, pushes that car to the top when it comes to cars in the price range from 80 to 120K. And then there's nothing, and then there's Porsche, for me personally. Maybe you have another interpretation of your dream build, but I really, really love the car so far, and I would really, really love to stay with it. And I just want to keep it. Thank you so much that you took part of the video, and thank you that you are helping with all the decisions we need to make with the modifications we are planning. And yeah, I'm just thankful that you're here and that you are supporting our channel while watching, while commenting, and put in all your input you want to see on that channel with the BMW, with other projects. Let's be open and let's share your thoughts. Thank you that you're here. See you next time. Peace out.